Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory to our Lord. Amen. Amen. To him all the glory, all the honor. Amen. Open your Bible in Psalm 8. In the book of Psalms, chapter 8. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let's start in verse 1. Psalm chapter 8, verse 1. Glory, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let's read. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. Who has set your glory above the heavens. Amen. Hallelujah. How excellent is your name in all the earth. Who has set your glory above the heaven. The psalmist used here the word excellent because he did not have another adjective to describe God. You see, it's too much about God. You don't have another word to use, another adjective to use about the awesomeness of God. He said, excellent. Amen? That's what happened when we come to worship God. We are short of words. There's no words to worship Him. Amen? You know, sometimes I start worshiping God and I get short of words. It doesn't matter, I'm worshiping in English or in Spanish. I'm short of words. And you know, I finish in tongues. Hallelujah. Thank you. And so that just, yeah, you know, no word, just silent, just tear. You know, come down my cheek and just raise my hands. Because no word.
Amen.
To describe him. There's no word. That's where the psalmist, he's short of words. He said, excellent. Hallelujah. You know, he's God. He's glorious. There's no word to describe him. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. You know, and the Bible describes God, you know, with many names because for different things. God's awesome. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's jump to verse 3. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter if you go with words. And really, we always come short.
That's right.
When we worship Him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Verse 3. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars, which you have ordained, hallelujah, thank you, Lord. When I consider, you know, when I meditate, when I see, I just wonder. That's why he's saying the song. What happened, you know, this David, King David, you know, probably, you know, in the night when he was meditating about by looking to heavens, you see the heavens, the star, the moons. He's talking about, he's not talking about the sun here, he's talking about moon, the star, how to be meditating in the night, looking. And you see, you know, look, God's so wonderful. Look at the glory of God. Look, God, you know, I put the star in the heaven. He set the star in the heaven, the moon. How great is God? How mighty is God? How glorious God,
man. Amen.
Hallelujah. He meditated, he pondered, you know, and those things. Hallelujah. To see God said those things in heaven.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Only an awesome God can do these things. He said, I consider. You see, I meditate on these things, God. Your heavens and the work of your fingers. He said, all these things, you create those things, and you yourself establish those things.
Amen.
And meditate on those things, you know, when you meditate on God and how awesome He is, how powerful as He is, you become settled in your heart that the God that loves you, He can take care of you.
Amen.
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 There's no fear. But you know, this God, and that's what David was meditating on those things. Remember the life of David, he was persecuted by Saul. Mm-hmm. And those rant, he just, the night, meditating about, man, God, I trust in you. Hi. If you did those things, you can take care of me.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. That's, you know, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
You see, the same way that He ordained those things, He ordained our path.
Yes.
Amen. We have to follow the path that He ordained for us. And He take care of us. And the way He take care of us. When we walking in that path that, that our Father has set for us, He take care of us.
Amen.
Don't be afraid.
Hallelujah.
Don't fear.
Amen.
Fear not, because I am with you. Amen. And that's what, you know, David, he's looking on this thing, the thing that God made with his own finger, he said, you take care of me. I know. Baby, things don't go well right now. I know you will take care of me.
Amen.
Because you're the God who created all those things with your own fingers.
Hallelujah.
You establish all those things. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. But you feel the peace of God in you?
Yes.
Can you say that you have the God for you, not against you?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And then he sees this, he continued meditating in those things. And then go, you know, let's go to verse 4. He said, what is man that you are mindful of him? You see, why you take care of man, God? What you think about man? What you put your heart on man?
Mm-hmm.
You see, God, He cares about us.
Amen.
Mm. Hallelujah. He cares about us. You know, the first man that God visited was Adam. Remember, God used to come and converse with Adam. Mm-hmm. You know, like man with his friend. And that's why, you know, David is meditating, considering those things. You know, you mindful of man. You can't visit Adam. He's thinking about those things.
Amen.
God, mm-hmm. What is man? That you set your heart on man to take care of them.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's what God used to be with Adam's. Come and converse with Adam as a friend. We are not a friend. Mm-hmm. See? Hallelujah. You know, in this verse, it's talking too about Jesus. Jesus was called the Son of Man.
Amen.
The last Adam, Jesus. The one who came to restore everything. Because remember, Adam lost everything. He lost even that fellowship that they used to have with God. Mm-hmm. And the Lord Jesus came to restore everything. Now we can have fellowship with God,
mm-hmm.
converse with God.
Hallelujah.
Anytime we want.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And be assured they take care of us.
That's right.
Amen. God Himself is mindful of us. I mean, think about us. And the thought that God has for us, good thoughts. Hallelujah, good.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Good thoughts God has for us. You know, because He loves us. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Hallelujah. You know, what is man? What is man? That you are mindful of Him. And those old men that you visit him. Hallelujah. You know, the answer is because he loved us. That's the answer.
Amen.
That's why he's mindful of us, because he loved us. Hallelujah. And because that love, what we lost, men lost, we are, he came and brought Jesus, came to our life to restore everything in our life. That fellowship that Adam used to have with God in the garden, Jesus came to establish or restore that fellowship again. Then now we can converse with God.
Amen.
And share his glory.
Amen.
And see his glory.
Hallelujah.
You see, where the first man lost in the garden, Jesus came and established in the garden.
Amen.
You see, lost in the garden and established in the garden. And that's something. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Glory to God. Get to restore everything in Jesus. The glory of God.
Amen.
In us.
Yes.
The glory of God's in men.
Yes.
You see, when Jesus came and what Jesus did was to restore all the glory. What was the glory of God? Jesus said, the glory that you have given to them. What the glory? The glory as a son of God. That's the glory we have.
Amen.
And that's the glory that men have to see in us, and the Redeemer, the glory that men have to see in the Redeemers. We are the Redeemer.
Hallelujah.
Okay? There's the glory as a song. He came to reestablish on Jesus. That's the glory that Jesus came to give it to us. The glory of the song.
Yes.
Because it was the first begotten song. But then he brought more song to glory.
Yes.
Hallelujah. That's you and me.
Yes.
Sons to glory.
Yes.
You and me. Jesus came to restore the glory of the Father in us. The glory of God in us.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Hallelujah. Let's go to Hebrews. Then we're going to come back to Psalm 8. But now let's go to Hebrews. We're going to go back and forth. Probably. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Do you hear Hebrews?
Amen.
I say Hebrews, right?
Yes.
Okay. Amen, amen. Let's go together and see the word of God in Hebrews chapter 2. Amen?
Amen.
Are you there?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hebrews 2. Verse 6. Amen? We are reading what the psalmist said in verse 8, in chapter 8 of Psalm. He said, but one testified in a certain place, saying, talking about Psalm 8, right?
Mm-hmm.
What a man that you are mindful of him. Hallelujah. What is man? We're going to go back to Hebrews. Let's go back to Psalm 8. We're going to come back in a minute. But you see, there. The writer of Hebrews is saying the same thing Psalm 8 is here, okay? What is man? Hallelujah. What is man? That you are mindful of him. Amen?
Amen.
Glory to God. You know, that's the answer. He loves us. And he came to restore us, establish us, and they restore us to the glory of song. We are sung the glory of the being sung of God.
Yes.
That's the glory. The glory of God in us. That we are his sons.
Amen.
Amen. That's the glory that Jesus gave to us. The glory as a song. Amen.
Amen.
Song and glory. Okay, the women know you're not a star. When there's a song, everybody there. Male and female. Daughters, sons. That's the glory of God in us. Amen? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Then you don't look for man's glory.
Amen.
God give you his glory.
Hallelujah.
As a son and daughter.
Yes.
Stop running around looking for the glory of man.
Amen.
God give you his glory.
Yes.
As a son and daughter.
Amen.
Amen? Hallelujah. Glory of God, amen. Verse 5. For you have made him, man, a little lower than the angels, and you have crowned him with glory and honor. You see, he already did. Hallelujah, he has crowned already him with glory and honor. You see. Even it's prophesied about Jesus, when he received the glory, he gave back to us as a son and daughter.
Yes.
The glory, Father, you are given to me, I give it to them. What glory is? That's a son and daughter. That's the glory.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Start looking for glory. You have the glory of the Father.
That's right.
As a son and daughter of God.
Yes.
Start looking for approval, man. You've been approved by God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You are God's kids.
Yes.
And he has given his glory. Jesus came to restore everything. Hallelujah. David, he was a prophet. He was in everything. God was showing everything to him by the Spirit.
Amen.
That's what we are. Start walking with the head down. You are son and daughter of God.
Yes.
And your Father has given his glory. He has crowned you.
Yes.
Be glory and honor.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
We glory and honor. You, Father. My Father. Remember when Jesus was teaching his disciples to pray? He said, our Father.
Yes. Hallelujah.
You see? He said, you are son and daughter of God.
Yes.
God's new Father, my Father is your Father.
Hallelujah.
And the glory I give to me, I give to you.
Hallelujah.
The glory of the son and daughter, you stay there.
Yep.
Look at your Bible. Amen. Start looking for other things. People think that you find glory in another stuff. No, you're already, you son and daughter of God, you born again. You have the glory of the Father. God put his glory as a son and daughter in you, in honor.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Amen. Sometimes we miss what God already have done in our life. And will it be love what I already established for us? He already established.
That's right.
Because you know the lie that we've been listening for many years. But with the sons of free indeed.
Hallelujah.
You are the glory of God.
That's right.
And that's why you live for his glory.
Yes.
That's why he put his glory in you. You live for his glory. Amen. You don't live for yourself. You live for the glory of your Father.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Luke 20. Luke 20. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. In verse 26, look at what he said here. Luke 20, he says, nor can they die anymore, for they are equal to angels. First, they are said a little lower than the angels. Well, now, equal to the angels. Amen. Hallelujah. And are sons of God. Being sons of the resurrection. That's what we are.
Amen.
Sons of God.
Yes.
Amen. That we're not no more little than angels, right?
Amen.
No more little lower than the angels.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Because we are sons of God.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. The glory of God knows, man.
Mm-hmm.
To live for His glory.
Yes.
You know, to live in attitude of worship to our Father all the time.
Amen.
In attitude of worship. You see, what is the attitude of worship? That we yield our life every day, yielding away our Father.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That we embrace who we are. Amen. In our life, that the glory of our Father is in us.
Yes.
Our sons and daughters. And we walk in that glory, not with pride, like the pride of man, but you know, surrender our lives to Him.
Yes.
Yielding.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Like our brother Jesus did. He was carrying the glory of the Father. By yielding his life and obedience to accomplish the will of the Father here in this earth.
Amen.
And we have to do the same as a son and daughter.
Yes.
We have the glory of the Father, for not to be all past time, prideful, and hurry.
Yes.
But yield our life to Him to do His will here in this earth.
Yes.
To live for His glory.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus chose the way.
Amen.
See, he don't consider it be equal with God. Mm-hmm. By humbling himself.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got the glory of the Father, but you humble yourself.
Amen.
Amen. To live for Him.
Yes.
That's a real life in the kingdom. That's the real life in the kingdom. For Him, not for ourselves.
That's
before
right.
His glory.
Yes.
Yeah. We humble ourselves.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory. Amen, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So when in the Bible, most in the Old Testament, they use the word angels, in Hebrew, say, Elohim. Amen. When the Old Testament, they use that word to mean God, you know, God, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, God, where God is complete. Amen. Or they use Elohim, they use supernatural beings too. Amen. That's the word they use when they use the word angels in the Old Testament. Elohim, talking about God or the supernatural beings. Amen. This, do you see here in the Word of God? That's why you have to go and see the truth. Okay? God loves us. And He gave the glory, His glory, as sons and daughters. To we live for His
glory.
Amen. You know, the glory that God gives us as a son and daughter not to be baptized.
That's right.
Just to live for His glory.
Yes.
Jesus did it. Jesus is our example.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
You live for the glory of the Father. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Let's go back to Hebrews chapter 2. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And now, you know, it's written. You have the glory of the Father. What is the glory? Sons, to be sons and daughters. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hebrews chapter 2. Now we're going to start in verse 5. Amen. We're going to read from verse 5 to 10. Hallelujah. Yes. For He has not put the words to come. Or we speak and suggestion to angels, but one testified in certain place, saying, we read that in some, right? What is the man that you are mindful of him, or the son of man that you take care of him? Amen? You have made him a little lower than the angels. You have crowned him with glory and honor, and saying over the words or your hands, give authority.
Amen.
To us, the Redeemer, sons and daughters of God. Jesus said, all authority in heaven has been given to me, and they passed it to us.
That's
right. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He said, you have put all things in subjection under his feet. Jesus, right? And they give it to the church, us.
Yes.
Because we are his body. Then everything is Jesus gave authority to us, the sons and daughters of God, the church. Mm-hmm. Authority. Dominion, power. You know, that's what we're king. King have dominion, have domain.
Hallelujah.
And God give a king, as a king, I give a dominion, power, authority, and whatever domain, whatever realm we are.
Yes.
But he's saying us, we have authority, power, dominion, over every evil spirit.
Then
whatever place we are, there's our domain, we have authority.
Yes.
Over every evil thing.
Hallelujah.
As king, and we declare and we proclaim.
Yes.
In the name of the Lord Jesus, as a king.
Mm-hmm.
Kings. He made us kings and priests.
Yes.
King declare.
Hallelujah.
King proclaim.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. Take your authority in the name of Jesus. Over all, every evil thing. And declare the goodness of the Lord.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Verse 8. For in thy put all in subjection under him, he left nothing that is not put under him. But now we do not yet see all things put under him, but we see Jesus, who has made a little lower than the angels for the suffering of death, crowned with glory and honor, that he by the grace of God might taste death for everyone. For it was fitting for him, for whom all things, and by whom are all things, and bring many. Are you see that? Many sons to glory. Hallelujah, to make the captain of the salvation perfect through sufferings. You see, it brings many sons to glory. Mm-hmm. What glory? The glory of God. Glory, what glory we're talking about? The glory to be sons and daughters. Many sons to glory.
Yes.
We always think about glory, oh, when I go to heaven, that glory. No, glory here in this earth. To be a son and daughter of God, taking authority.
Yes.
Not only son and daughter, but kings and priests.
Hallelujah.
And king can declare.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. We have to know this, embrace it, believe, because that's true.
Amen.
It's there. It is written. Is established in heaven.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Bring many sons to glory.
Yes.
And we won't read this within all heaven, the glory of no, here in the earth, as a son and daughter, the glory of the Father is in us. Yeah, give it the glory as sons and daughters, take authority and dominion.
Amen.
Son and daughter with power and authority and dominion. You see that, you better see it and believe it and exercise your authority and power as the sons and daughter of God and king and priest. Hallelujah. It is written. Look at yourself, Jesus. Written, it's written, believe it. Take God by his word.
Amen.
Believe it. Hallelujah. God's purpose meant not angels to be sovereigns or kings. All the created order. You see, we have domain here. We have authority over this thing. Our Father created.
Amen.
And give us the authority, the power, not to angels, to us.
Hallelujah.
You know, sovereign is kings. All the created things. That's the order of God. He gives authority over all things that he created. Jesus came to establish, to establish those things, to restore those things to man.
Amen.
All those things that are lost in the garden. Jesus came to the garden and restore all those things. You see that? From one garden to another garden. The first Adam to the last Adam.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. As the new eternal order inaugurated by the enthronement of Jesus, the man provided a way of escape from bondage. The man Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Exalting glories at God's right hand. And we and the world God said that we are sitting down with him in every place. Where Jesus sitting? In the right hands of God. So we there too.
That's right.
Place authority and power and dominion.
Yes.
You see you there? Amen. You better see yourself there.
Hallelujah.
Because that was the word of God there.
Yes.
Amen. He was exalted in glory at the right hand of God. And we are there. That's our position.
That's right.
No, I'm there.
Yes.
We're up.
Hallelujah.
No beneath, but above.
Hallelujah.
That's our position. In God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. See? That's what Jesus did. He provided the way. Or escape from bondage. To access to God's presence. An entrance into man's intended glory. You see? That's why he opened the door for us to enter in the glory of God.
Amen.
Into our position as a son and daughter, the position of glory, the glory of the Father as a son and daughter.
Yes.
Jesus opened the way in the garden. Hallelujah. Lost in the garden. Take a bite the garden. Hallelujah. Establish in the garden. Amen.
Amen.
That's what the order of God. That we are in the glory. God restored everything for men already. And for those that are outside, they just come to Jesus and they'll be restored too. He did it. It's done. It's finished.
Hallelujah.
God already restored us to our position. What do you want the God to do for you? He already did it. Amen. He did it. You see? Jesus, the man, exalted glory of God's right hand, occupied the position of dominion intended for men. That was God's heart for them from the beginning.
Amen.
The men rule here in this earth.
Hallelujah.
Okay?
That's right.
Not the devil. Men.
Amen.
The Redeemer. The sons and daughters of God. Not pulled here and there by the devil, but rule,
yes,
and dominion. God give us his glory, his authority, his honor,
yes,
King.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Let's go back to to Psalm 8. So we see the parallel with this chapter in Hebrew, talking the same thing Psalm 8 is speaking about.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. the same thing. Verses in Wilson 8. You have made him to have dominion, yeah, over the works of your hands. The same thing they say Hebrews, right? You have put all things under his feet. Hallelujah. If we're talking about Jesus, it's the same with us, because we are his church. We are his body.
Amen.
He's put under everything under his feet. We are the body of Christ.
Amen.
There's, we have authority over the thing. We're part of that feet. We're stepping.
Yeah.
We're taking dominion. We have to. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You have put all things under his feet. With all sheep and ocean. You know, that's why Jesus, when he said Peter, when Peter came to you, he said, Master, we need the money to pay the taxes. And Jesus sent him to go fish. And the fish came with the piece of money in his mouth. You know why? Because Jesus had dominion over all things. And when Peter was walking to fish, Jesus already said, fish, get that money and bring it to Peter. If we have dominion over things, can speak to things, and the same laws.
That's right.
Okay? You better start walking in faith. We have dominion.
Amen.
It's all cheap and also even the beast of the field, the birth of the air. And the fish of the sea, you see? And the fish of the sea. That authority, Jesus has authority over the sea. And establish back to us.
Yes.
You know, remember the disciples came out, they went to fish, and they don't got nothing. They were fishing, they were fishing, and they don't got nothing. And the Lord just said, throw the net aside. What happened? They got mighty catch. Then the net was breaking. Do you see? Because we have dominion over the fish.
Amen.
And that dominion over all things that are restored to us through our Lord Jesus.
Yes.
I remember one day, though, is what the people. It was, I went to my apartment, the big people was coming, man, the big lot of muscle. And I said, stop in the name of Jesus. He was close to me. And that big old people, your muscle. And the tail went between left and he turned around and left.
Hallelujah.
We have authority in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Look at here. You have put all things under his feet, all sheep and watch, even the awesome, even the beasts of the field, the birds of the air, and the fish of the sea. You see? Even the dogs. You're not listing up or everything.
Hallelujah.
He said, that pass to the path of the sea. Everything. Everything, dominion, authority. My God, we don't know who we are. And the authority that our Father has given to us, His glory they have given to us as sons and daughters. We don't know who we are. Playing church. Take your authority and start playing church.
Amen.
Take your dominion. Start playing church. Amen. And God set the captive free.
Amen.
Start playing around. Stop. God give you dominion over sinners and disease.
Amen.
Authority. Let's do it.
Hallelujah.
Stop playing church. Let's do it.
Amen.
Let's take our position.
Amen.
time. The time is now, not tomorrow.
That's right.
The sons of God have to be revealed in this earth.
Amen.
Jesus chose the way.
That's right.
We walk. He did it. Showing the Father, the glory of the Father, doing, taking dominion, destroying the work of the devil. And we have to continue as a church, as a son, and we have to continue doing this.
Amen.
You know what Jesus did? Destroying the work of the devil.
Hallelujah.
Because through our Lord Jesus, our Father, giving us authority, dominion, power. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. You better believe it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And look at how the psalm is finished. This song 8. Oh Lord, after he, you know, pondered everything, after he saw everything, he's amazed, you know. And that revelation that God given glory to man. It's, oh Lord, our Lord, the same way he started finished it. Oh Lord, our Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory to your name, Father. How excellent is your name, Lord. And all the years. Hallelujah. How awesome is God.
Amen.
Oh God. You know, you don't have no words. You don't find no words to describe God in His glory and what He has done in our life and what He has given to us. All the authority He has given to us. He has given His glory to us.
Yes.
As on the door. And the psalmist just said, oh Lord, our Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. And Jesus came to show the glory of our Father to us, to all the men and the earth, the glory of the Father. He did it. He took dominion of the work of the devil.
Yeah.
And we're supposed to continue. Because he has given authority and power, dominion. He said, we are king. And king declare, decree. And we have to do declare and decree in the name of Jesus against sinners, against disease, against with the thing that is not right.
Amen.
The thing that they're not according to our will, our Father. Those things that are not according to our Father's purpose. He has given the authority and power and dominion and given us His glory.
Amen.
He gives the glory of the Son. To all who believe in Jesus Christ. You're not a little Christian.
That's right.
You are sons and daughters of God.
Yes.
And wherever you go, you're taking the glory of God. Wherever place you go. And not only when you're in church service, oh, I feel the glory of God. No, it's to carry the glory of God.
Yes.
Too much feeling and not authority.
That's right.
No, we have to exercise our authority. Feeling, feeling here, feeling there. And nothing happened. If you feel a choice, Jesus was walking about feeling and feel. He did it.
Amen.
He chose. The disciples did the same. Hey, when you feel, I feel this, I feel that. I feel, you feel this, you feel that. No, no, nothing like that. They did. Thank the words, we do the same. Start looking for feeling. If the feeling can't find, but you don't come, you have to exercise the authority and the power that God gives you to you already, to Jesus Christ. He already did it.
Amen.
Then you don't wait until you feel something. Exercise. The glory. Exercise. Let God be glorified. Let your light shine before men, that they might see your good work and glorify your Father that is in heaven. How? Go heal the sick.
Amen.
Stop playing church. I feel, yeah, I feel. And nothing happened. Hallelujah. Let's glorify our Father.
Amen.
Doing the work. Jesus said that we will do the work, right? Greater work. And that's my Father will be glorified. Let's glorify our Father.
Amen.
Not only were we worshiping, but we were doing it. That's what we glorify our Father. When we were living His life, when He lived His life through us, we glorify our Father.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because I put His glory, and then let's put the glory of God, they put Him as a song and display for the world, and to put a chain in Satan. He's under our feet.
Amen.
He knows he's under our feet, but you know he's under your feet.
Amen.
Let's do it.
Hallelujah.
Let's do it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let's worship. Oh, glory to your name, Lord. How wonderful you are, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory, Father. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father God. How excellent. How excellent you are, Father. How excellent in your name. How excellent in your glory, Father. Hallelujah. Thank you. Forgive us your glory as the sons and daughters. And we carry your glory, Father. Whatever place we go.
Yes.
Father, and we take your lives and we do the work that you call us to do. That you be, may be glorified before me. That we heal the sick, that we cleanse the leper, that we raise the dead, and we cast out devils in the name of Jesus. And you will be glorified. You will be glorified,
yes,
in this
Lord.
Era, Father. You will be glorified to your sons and daughters in this era, Father. Because we live in the last hour, Father. Father, stand the revival, Father.
Yes,
it comes to your children. In your name be glorified. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen.